Hello, my name's Anthony Hall, and in this tutorial we're going to create a little basic spaceship. Now I've done a similar tutorial to this a few years ago, where I'm just going to update, kind of redo it, but using a few other techniques, and then I'm going to do a part 2 for how to UV it, and then a part 3 how we can maybe just do a little render and stuff. So let's get started. So for this tutorial, what I'm going to do is I'm going to follow an actual Maya tutorial that I did a few years ago on how to go at creating it. So, I mean, this one's about 5 years old by Edge CGI 3D Tutorials and More. But I'm going to kind of redo this tutorial, but using Lightwave and also, like I said, UV and stuff. So I'm going to start off by using the box tool and bring up numerical. I'm just going to extend it a little bit. So in this view here, look, a perspective view. Kind of get some, let's say like that. So drop the tool, and then what I've got is this basic rectangle. So what I'm going to do is make sure at the bottom I'm on polygons. I want to select both sides like so, and then we're going to make some kind of wings, maybe main body and wings. So go to multiply, multi-shift, bring up the numerical, make sure group polygons is on, and then I'm going to drag up and side to side to decide the kind of body I want and how far I want the main part of the body and wings to come out. So I'm going to go with, let's go with that. Now, while I'm still on the tool, I'm going to right mouse click to say I want to create another actual kind of bevel, and I'm going to bring it in to about, say there, just a little bit. Then I'm going to right click again, and this time I'm going to bring it out, making the ends a bit thinner, so you get this look like so. Okay, so I'm going to drop the tool, press spacebar. While they're still selected, let's go to modify move. I'm going to hold control on my keyboard and to stop it from going like side to side. I'm just going to bring the wings back, let's say to about there. Okay, I'll drop selection. Next, let's select the front poly here. Let's bring this forward. Keep on using multi-shift, one of my favorite tools. We're going to bring it forward a bit, about there. Then we're going to right mouse click to make another bevel, bring that forward, and then we'll bring it in, let's say to about there, like so maybe. Okay, let me zoom in a bit down here on my back view. I'm going to jump to move while it's still selected. Hold control on the keyboard. Let's just pull it down so it's roughly level with the rest of the ship, like so. Then deselect the actual poly. Select the edge tool. Now let's just select this edge here like so, and then with the move tool again, holding control, let's just move it down so it's a bit lower, just something like that. Yep, cool. Okay, so let's make some thrusters here now. So we'll jump back to the polygon tool. So I'm pressing my spacebar, look, and if you look at the bottom here, look, it's jumping between the selections, and then I'm going to hold shift and select both sides. Jump to the multiply tab, bevel, and let's hold control to lock it, the movement just inwards. I'm going to bring it in like so. So I've got this bevel, and then I'm going to right click and bevel again, but this time I'm going to bring it in and then also bring it in a little bit. So you've got this look like so. Spacebar forward slash, or you can click in here to drop the selection. So add a little rocket at the back. So I'm going to select the polygon, go to bevel, hold control, bevel it in, right mouse click, bevel it again a little bit, and then right mouse click. This time let's pull it back and in a bit, and then right mouse click again. So I've made a few bevels basically and drop the selection like so. Next, I'm going to select this top bit. So it's kind of getting there. Let's bevel the top bit. I'm holding control again to lock it. Let's bring it right in to here, like so. I'm then going to go to modify and move. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to move it roughly to near enough to the back, just about there. While it's still selected, let's go to multiply, smooth shift, and let's bring this up and in a bit, making this little back fin like so. While we're still on it, and it's got it selected, go to modify, move. Let's pull this back in line with the wings roughly. So control to keep it locked. Let's bring it back roughly. So you've got that. It's not bad. So what we're going to do now is if you go down to the bottom here, you've got, it'll be on subpatch. Click to Cat and Claw. I mean, you can try subpatch. So let's press subpatch and smooth it round nicely like this. So, and then the other option is another way of Cat and Claw. So it's kind of two different ways. I think Cat and Claw looks a bit better on this one actually, but again, it's kind of up to you which one, but we're going to stick with it. So what this does now is it subpatches it. So if you press tab, keep jumping between the tab to unsubpatch, so it smooths the polys out. When you take this through to layout, what you'll notice is the polys and everything will be like all filled in. So basically it's a bit like freezing it in here. So what I mean by freezing it is what it's done, it's curved all these polys into this shape. But if you go to construct, if you want to remove the actual subpatch but keep the shape, you need to click on freeze. And then what it does is removes the subpatch, and then you've just got the ship, but you've got quite a lot of poly. So again, that's up to you. But if I just save this, let's just save it somewhere as anything, should really name it properly. We just send it through to layout to show you what I mean. Okay, so here's a ship. Let's go on to texture shade. And you can see now what's happened. And this is based on when you're on the, when you're on the object, if you go to properties and then double click subdivide, this is based on the display subpatch level. So if I put this back down to zero, that's what you're getting. Now I can move it up, 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 and you can keep going if you want. So yeah, that's how you kind of control the kind of subpatch level in here if it's not frozen. So let's go back into here. So currently what I want to do is I've got my ship. Before I UV it, what I want to do is I'm going to add a line of edges splitting these two polys all the way around the ship, so I can chop the top and the bottom apart and lay them flat to UV. So to do this, what I'm going to do, I'm going to click these two polys here, go to multiply, and then we've got a tool called bandsaw plow. So click that, bring up the numerical, and you get this setting, default setting. You just need to leave the default setting. What it's done is it's added this line of edge, an edge line all the way through the actual ship. And because the poly, the ship's loopable, and the same amount of polys on both sides. And you can only really use this, really works well on loopable objects. It's added this extra low, splitting these two polys. So we can click shut, space bar, forward slash to drop it. But now what I've got is I've got this option now that I can select the top half of the ship and the bottom half to UV. So here's a ship ready to UV in the next part. So thanks for listening to this part of just making the basic ship. Check out my second part of how to UV it. Also, please share, subscribe, and check out my Lightwave Salvation Facebook group. Bye.